Hello, everybody. Star here. What is going on? I am alive. First of all, I am not dead. There's a certain amount of days where if I don't make a video, I will be pronounced dead. It's been a while. It doesn't feel that long to me, but I noticed there was an obituary in the paper and everything, so I was like, I should probably get on here and make a video and say, hey, what's up, everybody? We got a quick gameplay here. Not really so quick. I guess I've scout on Swiftwater, just running around, clicking on people with scatter guns, doing regular old scout things. And there's been a lot of stuff going on for me lately. For one, if you didn't hear, I am moving very soon. I was away these last couple of days looking for an apartment, which was stressful and annoying, and I'm glad that's over with, but I actually found a place. I will be moving March 1st. So if I'm not around for a couple of days around March 1st, I'm not dead. I'm just moving to Boston. Inner city Boston is... I'm excited. Whenever I get excited about something, too, that's like all I can think about. So, you know, I'm off picking out an apartment, doing all that cool stuff over there. I'm not, like, in the apartment saying, I wonder if I'll move here, but what is my video going to be on tomorrow? No, I'm thinking, I'm going to move. This is cool. So even now that I've been back for a day or two, I came back and I was just like, oh, I haven't made a video for a while. What the heck do I do? I still don't know. What am I even talking about now? Not really anything, but I'm here. But now that I'm here, what do we actually talk about? Maybe flamingos. Flamingos are actually pretty cool, but no, that's dumb. That's a bad topic. I think there actually have been a couple of interesting things that I've been kind of doing on Team Fortress 2. Not really so much interesting, but it's also been making it to the point where I'll play TF2, and normally I would do a live commentary, but I've been holding off on that because all the times lately I've been playing TF2, it's been to get used to something, because I've changed what I've done and I'm not feeling completely confident. I mentioned a couple videos back, or maybe it was even like one video because it's been that long. I got a new mouse, I was getting used to that. Then I got a new keyboard because it was like, I'm just changing everything up in here. And then I decided that, you know what, I'm changing my key config. I don't want to use the jump button anymore that I usually use. Because before, if you remember, I use F button to jump. No more. I'm calling it quits on F button to jump. So I had to get completely used to a new key, which didn't really take me as long as I thought it would. I'm still trying to get used to this. What I'm doing now, my jump button is mouse 2, which that might sound pretty crazy to some people, but mouse 2 is actually a lot of Quake players will use mouse 2 to jump because it makes it easier to bunny hop. In Tribes Ascend, or any Tribes game really, by default the jump button is mouse 2, or that will be your jetpack. So that's essentially jumping. And if we go way back, I used to play a lot of Soldat, and in Soldat you have jetpacks also, which were mouse 2. So mouse 2 is a little bit easier for me to learn to jump with than spacebar. I know, but it makes more sense to me, and I think in the long run I would like to use mouse 2. There's no mechanically wrong reason why mouse 2 is a bad thing to jump with. It's just a little weird if you guys haven't like thought about it or done it before, but I'm trying to do that. I'm used to jumping with mouse 2. That's like the easy part for me, but the weird part for me is now all of the secondary attacks in Team Fortress 2 are on spacebar. There are so many secondary attacks in this game, like I'm forgetting which one I need to press spacebar and what I don't need to press spacebar for. Like if I go on Pyro, Air Blast for Pyro is simply mouse 2. Everyone knows it's mouse 2. Everyone in the whole world knows this. You don't even have to play Team Fortress 2. Air Blast is mouse 2, okay? So that took a little while to get used to. I think I'm finally starting to press spacebar for that. But then every single time I pick a new character class or a new weapon that has a secondary attack, I have to like rethink the thing all over again. Because it's in my mind, I'm saying spacebar is Air Blast. Then I go on to Demo Knight and I try and charge and targe and I just jump in place. I'm like, okay, charge and targe, spacebar. For in my mind, I have to set every single one of these to spacebar and not just realize, oh, they're all secondary attacks. One of the weirder ones that took me a while to get was the Sandman. I am so afraid running around as a scout to press mouse 2 to jump when I have the Sandman out because I'm like, no, I don't want to waste my ball. And then I finally realize, okay, I have to press space to hit it. And then I hit the Sandman ball with space, it goes, it connects on the person, I switch to the Flying Guillotine to throw it at them to get that combo on them. You can't press space to do that. You have to throw the Flying Guillotine with left click because there is no secondary attack for the Flying Guillotine. It seems like you would because you're throwing it and you throw the Sandman. It makes sense, it's kind of weird. I wish Team Fortress 2 would actually just, why not let me throw it on secondary attack? I'm finally getting used to that, and I think for most classes that I play, I'm finally established that spacebar is what I need to press. And so now I've mostly got that all down. It's going pretty good for me, and I wanted to hold off on doing things like live commentaries or whatever while I'm, you know, talking to yourself while you're playing is distracting enough, let alone I'm trying to figure out what buttons I even need to press to play this game. Like, I want to figure out the playing the game should be not something you have to think about. If you have to think what button you're pressing every time you want to press it, that's a problem. So I'm just trying to get that settled for myself, and I think I'm finally getting to that point. And it's been a weird habit to break. I have been using the F key to jump since I was 8 or 9 years old. It's a really dumb thing to do. I've said this before, it's a dumb key to press. But originally, I did it in Medal of Honor Allied Assault, one of my favorite games of all time. I love that game. But in a game like Medal of Honor, if you jump, you don't need to airstrafe, you don't need to double jump back and forth. There's no, like, problem with that. It's just, there's nothing wrong with it. It makes a little bit of sense because you don't have to do all these weird, awkward movements. But when you're on scout, or when you're trying to airstrafe as a rocket jumping soldier, and you press F to jump, and then you need to strafe right, it's a little bit weird. So I finally decided I'm gonna relearn this. It's worth the time to relearn. Yeah, so anyway, that's enough about key configs. I know some people are just gonna be like, what's mouse do for jump? People just can't comprehend that. I mean, there are a lot of Counter-Strike players as well that use scroll wheel up or down to jump because it makes that, once again, a lot easier to bunny hop, but whatever. I've also been doing this on a new keyboard, like I mentioned. It's a mechanical Blue Switch Cooler Master keyboard. It's awesome. I've always wanted a Blue Switch keyboard, but I never really committed to buying one because I thought they'd be way too loud and they'd show up in my live commentaries and just annoy the poop out of everybody. But for one, I love the sound Blue Switch keyboards make. Get a little jiggle jaggle in there. It's not too loud. It's not as loud as I thought it was going to be. It's not any louder than my last keyboard was. It's just a little bit of a different sound. But really, I love the sound of it. I love how the keys press. I have a thing with keyboards. It's nice. It's like watching fighting games. I like to hear the sound of someone smacking away on their arcade stick. That sounded really wrong. Yeah, so anyway, we're gonna wrap it up here. This gameplay is pretty much coming to a close soon anyway, and I just want to say, in ending here, yeah, I know I haven't been able to make videos very consistently lately, but the theory currently is, theoretically, when I move into the new place March 1st, it's going to be so much easier for me to make videos. I'm really hoping it. Everything points to, yeah, it's going to be a lot easier to do stuff, but after I get settled in on March 1st, we'll see how that goes. I had a couple of other things I wanted to talk about in this video, but I can't, so I got some cool stuff coming up for you guys. I have been working on things. So, yeah, watch out for that. Peace out, everybody.